Hello friends, so in this video we are going to learn about array of structures, pointer to structures and self-referential structures. Okay, so first of all, we know that for a primitive data type, we can have an array as well as a pointer. And a structure is a user created data type. So for a structure also, we can have an array as well as a pointer. Okay, let's see how to declare a structure for a array for a structure called employee. So let's take an example of integer. If I want to create an array of integer, how I am going to do it? Data type, then array name, and then size. Okay, this is a way to declare a array for integer. Similarly, for a structure, we are going to use a struct keyword first, then the data type, which is employee, okay, then the array name, that is employee, and then suppose we have 10 employee, then array size will be 10, and this is a declare of employee array of size 10. So how we are going to declare a array of a structure? A struct keyword first, then the data type name as compared to here, and then the array name and its size. Okay, so how to put value in particular section of a structure of array? Okay, suppose I want to update values for employee 1, first employee. So the index is going to be 0. So emp.emp id equal to 1. Okay, similarly, if I want to update salary, then emp.salary equal to some value, and similarly for department id, just emp0 and then emp0.department id equal to department id. Okay, so this is a way to put value in this array of structures. Similarly, if I want to update information for employee 2, then emp1.employee id, emp1.salary, and emp1.department id. So this is the way we are going to update the values. And to again print the value, what we are going to do is similarly put print here, printf, and then we are going to use this thing, that is emp0.employee id to print employee id, and for .salary for salary, and .department id for department id. So this is very simple. And now let's move to pointer to a structure. Like another variable, we can have a pointer. So for a structure also we can have a pointer. Let's compare it with a primitive data type. So suppose I have declared a integer called a and it is initialized to 5, then how am I going to do a pointer operation on it? That is, first we are going to declare an integer pointer and going to put address on it, okay, address of it, and then to print the value, what I am going to do is ptr and then asterisk. So similarly for a structure, we are going to do the same thing, but there is one twist. As pointer, a structure is going to have multiple items or multiple variables, so to retrieve data from a structure, we are going to use this arrow symbol. Okay, now let's see how we are going to deal with pointer of a structure. Sorry, pointer to a structure. Suppose for this employee, I have created one employee variable, emp1. Okay, this is the structure I have created, and I have put a value in it, 20,000 and then 2. Okay, So in next step, what we are going to do is we are going to declare a pointer for this employer structure, okay, equal to address of emp1. Okay, now this pointer will point to this thing. Okay, now how to retrieve data from it? Okay, now this ptr is going to point to this thing. So to retrieve data, we are simply going to do ptr arrow and then empid to print out the value of empid, and ptr arrow mark then salary to print out the salary, and ptr array department id to print out the department id. So the one thing to note here is we are going to use this arrow mark to retrieve the value from array using a pointer. Okay, now let's see the third point. What is self-referential structure? Self-referential structures are those structures where we are going to have one or multiple pointers which are pointing to the structure of same type. That is, let's take example. To first, we need to create a self-referential structure. Okay, we need to define it. So here, struct, employee, keyword, data type name, and then we are going to declare the elements. So one of the elements of this structure is struct employee pointers. So what is this? PTR is a pointer which is going to point to, or that is keep the address of a structure employee only. Okay, so what is going to happen is, suppose this is employee1, okay, employee1 is going to have three things. One is employee ID, second thing is salary, and third thing is pointer path. Okay, similarly, if I have employee2, we are going to have three things, that is employee ID, salary, and third part is pointer part. And what is this pointer going to contain? This pointer is going to contain address of a similar structure. Okay, that is, for example, you can say address of this employee2. Similarly, this employee2 is going to contain a address of employee3, and we can reverse this too. That is, we can put address of employee2 in employee3, address of employee1 is employee2, and employee1 is going to point to a null address. Okay, so this is a self-referential structure. And friend, this self-referential structure is very important because we are going to use it in stack, queues, linked list, as well as tree and graphs, okay, and some more other data structures also. So we are going to learn it in detail in other videos also, along with linked list. Okay, and I am going to come up with a list of videos of linked list. Okay, so if you have liked this video, then please like, share and subscribe, and thanks for watching.